drag it round here so to prove that that's where we are. And we're just before Dave Sharp is on, folks are starting to arrive for what is the kind of wind down gig for the Alarms weekend. It's Rebecca, isn't it?
No, Rachel.
Rachel. I had both in my head. Rachel, thank you. We met last night, and yourself?
I'm Mel.
Mel, we met last night.
Yes.
You were knee deep in t-shirts.
Yeah, yeah.
At the beginning of the night. So, and there was a far less t-shirts at the end of the night than
yes,
there was.
Yes. Oh, we sold out of some designs very soon. Yeah. Yeah, they were selling like hotcakes.
So, and the other thing that was remarkable, I said to you as if you might not know this, that it was Dave Sharp's birthday yesterday.
Aha!
And you said?
I always remember Dave's birthday.
Yeah.
Never left my mind.
Yeah, because that was your...
My first Alarm gig was in 88.
Yeah.
And it was, yeah, like, exactly to the date 35 years ago.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
So, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so Dave's birthday party.
Yeah,
Dave's
and there was also, it was in the Paradiso in Amsterdam, there was also
the
Dave's birthday.
The Paradiso is a great venue.
Yeah, they brought a cake on stage for Dave, with candles lit.
I think
and
there was
everything.
A cake involved last night as well,
in the
dressing room. Lovely. Yeah. So how long have you been doing the merch for the
How long now? I think since... not long, I think about 5 years now.
Okay.
Since 2018, was it then?
I'm not honestly sure.
And when was your first Alarm gig?
1990.
It was 80.
When
they
played
Green Belt.
So that's
kind of
quite late on.
I was there.
That was kind of quite late on in the Alarm.
It was, but I'm a bit younger than everybody else. So I missed out the early stuff on the grounds that I was about 10.
In a pram.
Yeah, not quite.
And I haven't introduced myself. I'm Rob Ellen. And
hi.
What's your role within all of this? Is there,
anything I don't do?
Yeah.
So I work for Mike. I'm Mike's lighting engineer.
Cool.
I'm also Mike's DJ, it seems. I look after walking music, general road technician, primarily lighting.
Yeah.
But
there's
not much we don't do.
It's got pretty busy just recently, hasn't it?
Just about to.
Yeah, seems to be. You're going all over the world with this show, aren't you?
Yeah. They actually visa'd us all up literally 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And then COVID kicked in.
Yeah.
So, you know, 3 year visa, I haven't had a chance to use it yet. So, yeah. Off to New York in June, is it?
Yeah.
So we've got the acoustic tour, which I only found out
That's
about
a nice
yesterday.
Tour. That's some really nice little venues.
Literally found out about that yesterday.
Yeah. And Switzerland. I seem to see. Is it?
Yeah.
I know nothing about that one.
I saw some banners and don't quote me. Just reading the banner.
No, there was the Alps Rocks, wasn't there? Yes.
What is that?
I don't know.
Okay.
I know no more than you do. I wasn't actually in that speech because I was busy.
Okay.
I was busy focusing lights at that
you must
point.
You must have been in the big... nice light show, by the way.
Thank you.
Really
it was
cool.
A good gig. It was a really
good
gig.
Sound was fabulous.
The nice thing with working lights for Mike is, you know, I've been a fan forever.
Yeah.
So I'm not just here professionally, I'm here as a fan.
Yeah.
I've got coffee tattooed on my shoulder.
That kind of seems to be the way that it's kind of, the fans are part of the family anyway.
Yeah.
And then one or two of them, like Rachel, pick up the reins and do...
Yeah, and like
do some
myself.
Work for them.
Yeah.
And like yourself, yeah.
I was just lucky to end up working for Mike.
Yeah.
Because he knew who I was, he knew I was a fan, and then I said, you know, I moved into working lighting, and he invited me to come and do lights, and gradually ended up doing more and more and more.
So is that you? Is that you all broken down with the conference?
Yeah, we're finished. We're finished in venue recovery now.
Yeah.
So I go back to the day job of lighting other gigs.
Yeah.
So I've got what have I got this week? I've got a Bon Jovi tribute later on in the week, and I can't remember what else.
Yeah.
But yeah, it all goes
to be hectic. It's starting to be back at work time now.
Yeah. Well, I've been back at work for most of a year now. And the busiest I've ever been.
I'm pleased to hear it.
But yeah, Mike knows, because I'm a fan from ages back, he knows that wherever he goes,
yeah,
he's going to struggle to do something I don't know.
Yeah.
And he trusts that wherever he goes, I can go with him.
Yeah.
So when it all went wrong last night and he dropped into second generation, you know, really early song,
yeah,
he knew that I'd be there straight away.
Ah, I see. I didn't. Well, yeah, none of us noticed the join, so that's what you did.
Yep.
Excellent. Yep. Okay, so Mike's away now, is he, or is he still
No, he's probably actually watching the football at the moment because Wrexham are playing.
He's a Wrexham fan, of course.
No, he's a Man U fan, but yeah, he'll be watching the Wrexham game. Right.
Okay, well, it's a delight to be here. Nice to meet you girls as well. Thank you very much for doing this. We are at Tiffany's in Llandudlo, which is the sweetest little gig, and folks are arriving downstairs, a little jazz bar gig. Let's take a wander down and see if I can find the owner. His name's Simon. That's the stuff.
Shut up and booze.
So I'm live. At Tiffany's for iMTV. David Sharp coming up in just a bit. Folks arriving for the show. There's Gordy. Hey, Inverness.
Yeah. Stuck in deepest, darkest North Wales.
Yeah. The worst place to
stay. Place and it's cold.
So, you're doing the door and everything else for Dave,
yeah. As well as other things, yeah.
Yeah. Good weekend?
Busy weekend, yeah, very busy. Yeah. It's been quite hectic.
Do you help out with the alarm stuff as well?
No.
Just make sure Dave's looked after me. Yeah, to make sure it's sound.
Well, just make sure everything
stays good
for myself and Matthew.
Quick work, Simon. He's trying to avoid it. Quick word. Quick word when you get a minute. Right, I'm doing a bit of filming, just some back of the steam stuff.
Yeah.
Do you mind if I have a chat on here?
Yeah, have a chat.
Great, I'm Rob.
Hi, Bob.
And you are?
I'm Pete.
Pete, nice to meet you, Pete. Sorry? Hannah, nice to meet you. Are you here for the conference?
For the conference? I don't know about that, we're here for Dave Sharp.
I know, I'm just out of a conference and that was just telling me. Were you here for the whole gathering? Or
yes, yeah, we're here for the gathering. Been there, done that, seen that, and now here to see Dave.
It's quite loud, so I'm hoping that they'll pick this up. So have you been a long-term alarm fan and took today through the alarm?
From about 1983.
83?
Yeah.
Right, you must have been at school then and lying about your age to get into these places.
Yeah, I was at school first gigs. So South London, so used to see him at Hammersmith, Odeon, at Bristol Academy, at the Marquee.
I would have liked to have seen the alarm at the Marquee,
yeah,
I must say.
Fantastic, absolutely brilliant. brilliant Welsh language gig in the Shaw Theatre.
Okay.
And the infamous gig.
Nice.
In Brixton. Nice. So, yeah.
And do you catch up with Dave from time to time on his trails as well?
We've seen him a few times. Yeah. I booked him when I was at uni.
Oh, good.
He came in 1993.
That's when I met him.
Right.
1992, he came in with the Barnstormers.
Right, yeah.
Met in that hard travelling tour, one back after America. So you probably had... That,
well, he came on his own, so he came with Stuart. Came with Stuart.
Ah, I've met his brother.
Over to Bolton. Yeah, he did a gig for us. He was absolutely fantastic.
He is. This is just going to be perfect for Dave.
Yeah.
This is going to be rocky. You got the front row seats.
Oh, well.
This is what we hope for.
That's what we want to see. Yeah. It's good to see Dave in his element.
And in such good form as well. Yeah. He's killing it at the moment. So I'd like, I don't know if Simon, the manager, is going to show up. So that's fine. We've covered his venue. As far as I can gather, it's quite a new enterprise. And they want to do as much stuff here as possible. And it is... It's the best possible atmosphere for a little small gig, isn't it?
Yeah, not been here before, but it's fun.
There's a bar downstairs, there's a little jazz club that happens from time to time. So if you're in North Wales, definitely a focus for some good live music. And you know what I like about this? There isn't anything I don't like about it, but that stage, I love a venue that's got the stage in the corner. Because the sound is just going to be fabulous. So that's us. We're looking forward to the gig. I'll come back and I'll be doing some live broadcast from the show as well. Thank you. Thanks, Tiffanys, for having us. And we're out of here.